What images or thoughts pop in your head when you think of science and research? For most of us, images of beakers filled with liquids, atoms and molecules, or white lab coats come to mind. For others, science concerns specialized terminology used in physics or biochemistry, as seen above, that only a few people in the world can understand. Because of these preconceptions, many researchers, and even the general public, view psychology as a misfit puzzle piece among the sciences. In this Psychedemia episode, I explore the misconceptions surrounding psychological research, and most importantly, why research is so vital to psychologists. While psychology emerged as a scientific discipline over a century ago, critics still question, is psychology real science? The psychology isn't real science argument plagues social media, like this editorial written in the Los Angeles Times. Researchers try to make the argument that some disciplines are more scientific than others because of their level of rigor or experimentation techniques. But just because psychologists don't study proteins or bacteria, for example, doesn't mean the research is less thorough or objective. Maybe why many members of the hard sciences see psychology as a misfit is because of what psychologists study. In chemistry, for example, researchers examine atoms, molecules, chemicals, metals, and states of matter. In biology, researchers look at cells, genes, organisms, evolution, and anatomy. And in physics, researchers investigate motion, energy, force, time, and space. But what about psychology? What do psychologists study? In psychology, researchers primarily study people or the human experience, people's attitudes, behaviors, thoughts, feelings, and emotions. For this reason, many members of the hard sciences see psychology as a pseudoscience, a set of beliefs and practices mistakenly regarded as a true science, like phrenology or astrology. Furthermore, they see psychology as a discipline only concerned with people's subjective feelings and emotions, topics that vary from person to person and culture to culture. Despite this skepticism, psychologists study multiple topics adhering to the principles of the scientific method. Psychologists conduct rigorous studies on how colors influence our mood, for example. They study why people vote for and connect with certain politicians. They study how social media is changing social interactions. They study twins and the influence of genetic and environmental factors on personality development. Psychologists investigate how virtual reality can be used to help people overcome their fears. They study how sleep deprivation affects the speed at which we solve problems. And with the advent of modern technology, psychologists are even studying the biological basis of mental illness, memory, social cognition, and problem solving. So why is research so vital in psychology? Foremost, we cannot always trust our intuition or common sense. We often hear phrases like, go with your gut feeling and trust your instincts. But decades of research has shown that our intuition is often unreliable and can lead us to make poor decisions, like betting on sports based on a gut feeling. One of the criticisms of psychology is that it is all common sense. Ironically, the purpose of psychological research is often to investigate common sense and determine what is true and what is false. Another reason psychological research is vital in psychology is because people are generally overconfident. That is, people tend to misjudge how much they think they know. Research suggests that people tend to overestimate their level of knowledge, skill set, their estimation of how long a task will take to complete, and even how much they can control a situation. Overconfidence can lead to poor decision making, which is why psychologists rely on empiricism. Lastly, research is vital in psychology because of common errors in our thinking. Psychologists often point to the hindsight bias or the I knew it all along phenomenon to demonstrate one of these errors. Like looking into a crystal ball, hindsight bias is the tendency for people to believe, after an event, that they knew the outcome of the event before it actually occurred. Take a football game, for example. Under pressure, the quarterback throws a touchdown to win the game in the final seconds. Even though no one could foresee with 100% certainty the outcome of the game, it is common for fans to think, after the fact, that they predicted a touchdown pass to win it. What makes a discipline scientific? If you answered the topics, then it makes sense why you view psychology as a pseudoscience or a misfit puzzle piece among the sciences. But a scientific discipline is not defined by what researchers study. Rather, it is defined by the methods or process used to explain a given phenomena. Psychologists, along with physicists, chemists, and biologists, observe, collect data, and use evidence to draw conclusions and formulate new ideas. They rely on empiricism.